itself beyond present self, super self, being present. It's mainly a set of occurrences, a set of evasions, a set of refusals to see that one really is great, that one really has multiple levels of consciousness, that one has super intelligence, that one has extreme sensitivity with respect to others, that one has deep empathy, sympathy and love, that one somehow communicates in both directions with other beings, other entities in the universe and in realities which we do not talk about or perceive directly in the present state. One problem in human existence is the tendency to repeat feeling, thinking, action, again and again and again, in the same kind of looping cycle. It is as if one is controlled by a set of loops of tape. On these tapes are recorded what one says on one track, what one feels on another track, what one does on a third track. These are endless loops, and one tends to repeat things again and again and again. We will illustrate by using repeating words, repeating sentences, and repeating ideas, how one can get involved in such repetitional processes, and what sort of traps, blind alleys, evasions, hindrances, and refusals can develop in the face of such externally forced repetition. The point of these exercises is to make you more aware of the repetition process occurring in your body, in your mind, in your feeling, and in your relationships with others. How you avoid achieving your goals by repetitive methods. How your relationships with others repeat. How you use them in the service of a blindly repeating habit. How your capacity for repetition apparently is infinite. How your orientation is not aware of these repeating patterns. And how the large numbers of these must be eliminated from your functionality. How you must assimilate more open-ended, longer term loops, one side of which will be not certain that you become one's impulses tend to push one around such circles, especially if there are two forces on two impulses, one counter to the other, the so-called double bond. One can go circular indefinitely and counteract the impulsive forces. One's needs for repetition are such that one tends to repeat in order to be safe. Safety. Tremendous. Safety. you know how the possibilities of widening out these things make them so huge that at this lifetime, does not see it right now. The form of such repetition is obvious. It tends to be circular or elliptical. It's very simple. One would very much like to change the form into some sort of a spiral at least. A spiral of energy. This is one of the possible conversions of the substance. This is quite counter to